Okay, now we want to talk a little bit more about constructing parts for a song, which is essential. I'll give you an example. You know, one of the songs that on Don's record that we co-wrote together is a song called Uncharted Territory. Is that the title?
Yeah.
No, it took a while to name that one, didn't it?
Yeah.
But to give you an example, this has a riff in the beginning, which is a motif, which means a melody. So I've got a little delay. I've got a filtered effect on it to create the effect. On the record, I think it might have even been a slide. I can't remember, but it's a signature part of the song. So that's what I would call a motif. So it comes back around at the end of the song. It starts the song off. But then we're going right into a verse, and I'm going to demonstrate as we do that how I can be a little more atmospheric, and I'm going to be utilizing what we would call a pad type approach, and a term that you may or may not have heard before is a diamond. And all that really means is when you get to a chord, you hit it one time. That's a diamond. So if you ever hear somebody say diamond on the one or diamond on the four, that just means when you get there, don't keep playing. Just hit it and let it ring for the duration of the bar. So let's play the beginning of that intro, Don, together, that song, and I'll go from that to the atmospheric. All right.
Find myself in uncharted territory. Never felt so lost, never felt so lonely. Where are you, Lord? I'm so afraid, I can feel the fear inside me. Can't control the chaos all around. Sing the Lord's song in a foreign land.
So it's a good example. So far, I've not played anything that required playing multiple rhythms or notes at a time. So the diamonds and the pad created a little bit of life around a song. Not to mention, if we were in the full band setting, you would have guys in the band playing different parts. So now I'm kind of in the background creating color and texture more than I'm contributing to a part. But that, or I say I am contributing as a part of the song, but I'm not dominating that part. So in the beginning of a song, typically in an intro section, you may have a lead, but you may have nothing. And so the importance of parts comes into play right from the beginning in a song. And here's how I like to think about it. I've always seen the song as being kind of a linear graph. If you picture a flat line, it needs to ebb and flow. So at the beginning of a song, as you're looking at it, songs need to do this, and they need to build, they need to come down, then they transition. And part of that journey is what helps us to build emotion and express emotion, and we feel emotion as songs do that. And so my contribution as a guitar player is important, because I'm one of the colors that's going to be painting throughout this journey on this graph. So.